Hey, how's it going, everyone? Welcome back to Let's Play Vanquish. Last time, we fought two Argus robots at once, and we're only gonna get a short cooldown before it starts to really ramp up heavily again. Vanquish is just about all bombast almost all the time. So we're gonna get a short one-minute elevator ride, where we talk to Burns a little bit, and then we're straight back into the action with a string of really chaotic missions.
Gray Fox 1-5, can you get us to that central building?
Negative, Bravo 6 Actual. The central building's in the colony's center ring. We just can't get a transport ship in there.
Why not?
An installation on Grand Hills using a directional transmitter to jam all our frequencies. Our nav systems won't work between the northern and central rings.
Then find a way that doesn't use your navigation systems.
There is no other way apart from walking up to that jamming transmitter and turning it off. Sir.
Fine, Gray Fox 1-5. Then what's the sit-rep on enemy force strike?
Not positive on that yet, Bravo 6 Actual. But I figure they've got to be dug in pretty deep by now.
Bravo 6 Actual, over.
Bravo 6 Actual, this is Dead Fruit Gold 5. Encountering resistance on Grand Hill. Casualties heavy. Repeat, heavy resistance and casualties. Over.
Gold 5, estimate force strength. Over.
Fuck. Not inspiring confidence here, Burns.
We need to take that damn hill.
Is it strategically important?
They teach you those big words at DARPA Fancy Academy. No pussyfooting up here, ladies. We run out and we take them down.
Affirmative, Bravo 6 Actual.
Let's try that again. Hopefully I get a lock-on laser out of here. Nope. Actually, it's not even a lock-on laser I want just yet. I mean, I want one for the part coming up, but for right now, I'm fine with what I have. So what I want to do is I want to get an angle on this, shoot the rider off, and then commandeer it to clear out this floor. Oops. Alright, so far so good. This part is really tame by comparison to what's coming up. In fact, what's coming up makes everything that we've done so far look pretty tame. I'm not kidding when I say this and the next couple of missions all in a row are incredibly chaotic. They're just kinetic and frantic, and there's some really, really strong sequences there coming up. Partially because we're going to have to take several hills in the next few missions. Our first hill that we have to take is this one right here, and it's just as hellish as it sounds. It's bullets and missiles just being rained down on you overhead. So this is where I want to lock on laser, and I think there's one over here. So we'll be switching out the LFE gun for the lock on laser, just so I can clear out some of this tidal wave of Gorgis and automated missile turrets and point defense turrets. There is a lot to unpack on this hill. It's one downside to the lock-on laser, is if you have something directly overhead, your missiles may not make it to their destination. So the lock-on laser is prioritizing some of these automated turrets in the missile launcher, which it just took out. And that's totally fine. Even if this just softens some of this stuff up, including the Gorgis, that's totally okay. I'll switch this out for a rocket launcher so I can use that on a Romanov later. The biggest threat that I honestly wanted to get rid of from a safe distance was the rocket launcher up there on the bunker. That thing causes no small amount of problems. Also, EMPs are your friends in cases like this, except when you can't shoot them at midair. Ooh, that radius is still huge. EMPs are so damn good, especially in situations like this. It can really save you some headaches. So we just want to proceed kind of cautiously and methodically uphill. Yeah, I think I can make use of this disc launcher after we're done taking the hill for a later section. Use another EMP. Now we have, let's see, we have turrets to deal with overhead. Actually, I think I can ignore those turrets. So we'll take cover behind here. God, is that a grenade I heard, or was that Gorgie going critical? Shit. A wave of them spawned in as I was advancing. I was a little more careless than I would like to be right now. It's fine, we have a chance to catch our breath behind here. Yeah, even if I wanted to, it would be a pain in the ass to destroy those turrets, so we can just kind of safely ignore them now that we're more than halfway up the hill. And next, we can proceed into here, where a bunch of them are about to spawn. First kill went smooth, that one did not. You can tackle this two ways. And the way that I chose to try to do this, I'm assuming I'm about to die, but I don't know. The way that I chose to do this is by far the riskier of the two ways you could go about it. You can get close to the top. I might still pull this off. You can get close to the top, let the enemy spawn in, and just do your thing real slowly. Draw them out one by one, maybe lob some EMPs in. Or you can go in like I like to do, and just try to clear the whole room all at once. You need things to work in your favor. Otherwise, you usually wind up dead. That's why I like having the disc launcher around sometimes. Because like I said before... Oh, there is a sniper overhead. The disc launcher melee, unlike other weapon melees, does not overheat your suit. It just uses one disc of ammo. Let's see if I can decapitate him. Nah. The disc launcher is unfortunately kind of weak. It's good at softening up a group of enemies because it ricochets around. Even if you fire it at the wall, it'll still ricochet and home in on enemies. But the only way to kill even the weaker Gorgis instantly with the disc launcher is to decapitate them, so you need a headshot. And it's a bit of an unwieldy weapon. Now we can just clear the rest of the hill out for the rest of the Marines and Burns. And that's one section taken care of. This is not even close to the most chaotic sequence we have coming up. I can think of at least... Oh, shit. Where is that coming from? I definitely heard a Gorgie go critical that time. If they explode next to you, they do one-shot kill you, so... Something to be aware of. No, I don't want the rocket launcher yet. Not yet. Eventually, but... I think I could still make good with this disc launcher melee for a little bit here. Whoa! Straight up Doom 3 style monster closet right there. And there! Ooh! Ooh. That's okay, we can manage. It's just two of them. I'm not sure where the one behind me went. He took cover somewhere. Yeah. I figured he was around another corner. Oh shit! Shit! Get. I can't believe he actually kept up with me. I guess it's all the tight space and all the corners I had to turn that slowed me down. Yeah, they're insanely fast. When they're just crawling around decapitated, ready to kamikaze you. Holy shit. Wait, is there a crate I missed down? No, okay. That's the one right over here. Is that going to give me a rocket launcher again? No, shotgun this time. Not what I was after, but it'll Magazine capacity increased 40%. Excellent. Okay, I'm going to be ready for the monster closet this time. If at first you don't succeed, try again. I'm really not going to alter my game plan all that much. I'm just going to be a little bit more careful. Let's see how that works out for me. Okay, so we get two of you spawning over here. Ah, wasn't quick on the draw. That's okay. We can get the shotgun out and deal with them. Okay, this time... Oh, there was a corner that I... Okay. Oh, no. Yeah, take care of that threat before it crawls too close to you. All right, so far, so good. So far. So good. So far. There's one more that just spawned behind me. Let's do that. Yeah! That's my favorite melee attack to use. It's not always the most practical, but it is the coolest by far. Maybe the AR is a little bit cooler. Oh, there's something that I actually forgot to mention, when I was talking about melee attacks in a previous episode, the shotgun's melee attack can be charged up if you just hold the button down for a bit. Oh, hell. Whoop. We're slowly getting the shotgun up to where I would like it to be. This thing becomes unstoppable with some of the later upgrades. I think that should be the last of the Gorgis spawns here. So we're safe to just... Nope! I am so wrong! Luckily, I had decent reactions there. So wrong about that. Okay, now we're free to kind of look around. There's a crate that I know I'm missing. Oh, there's a lower level over here. This is just a maze of freight containers. So, fun note about the Gorgis color scheme. Mikami wanted them to be white, but they were too hard to see because the primary background colors that the game uses are like gray and white. So the Gorgis had to be changed to red to stand out against the background more. The only other Gorgis that we see are gold, so we have red and gold Gorgis, both of which contrast pretty well to the background. And even with their color palette swap, they could still be a little bit difficult to see at times, especially when you're dealing with, holy shit, with battlefields this big. I think I told this story before about how the battlefields were supposed to be a lot more open in the original design of the game. I believe Mikami's only regret about pulling back the scope of the battlefields like that was that it lets you use your suit's boosting power a lot less now. Although, if you're still limited by the green gauge, by overheating, wonder how much more you would have really been using the suit's boost mechanic, even with the more open battlefields, unless you're able to use it more often in the original design of the game. Not sure. Huh. Okay. I would like to have an LFE here, but you know what? No, I can get an angle on him right from behind cover below his turret. That's cool. This hill isn't quite as tough to take as the first one. There's a third hill in, I believe, the next mission that is one of the most chaotic in the game. We're going to be fighting uphill quite a bit, and there's some of the best sequences I find in the game. There we go. Deal with the stragglers. Now we can get inside. Yeah, this one's not bad at all, because they don't flood you with things that can perforate you. Just fill you full of holes. Now we'll use the boost kick, because that's fucking awesome. And hand grenade upgrades. Capacity increased by one. Nice. I don't find myself using the hand grenades too often. There, I find them to be a lot more situational than the EMPs.
We're gonna have to breach that gate. Elena, help us out here.
I tried hacking, but they put analog locks on it. You're going to have to blow that gate up.
Gonna need some heavy explosives. Demo team up front. Everyone else provide fire support.
Alright, now we have to cover the engineers so they can blow the gate up, but we're in the perfect spot to do that from. We have a nice overhead position, we have high ground up here, and we have a good open space we can retreat to if we really need to some breathing room. There's an upgrade down there that I don't want to forget, and an injured marine that I can help out once I take that last Gorgie out. Now we can go back downstairs, and I think that's it for this mission. Oh, he dropped an LFE.
We're at the gate! Setting charges now!
Alright.
The demo team has set their charges.
Oh,
you
whoops.
Need to get away from that gate.
No!
Go, go, go!
Please let me go back. Please. Please. Why is it locked behind you? Oh. Oh, well. It's a nice consolation prize, me and peas. So we have another short cooldown before things get even more hectic than they were before. And we have a really nice view here, too. Something to appreciate before we start blowing shit up again. Again, nice, nice view of the colony. God, that's so cool. They put so much effort into the background, into stuff that you will almost, you will probably never see. You could play this game 5 times, and every time, I guarantee you'll notice things that you never noticed before in the background, in the scenery, in the battles that are being fought in the horizon. It's so insane. Another really good view. Oh my god, this game is a looker. This is one of those rare games where it's, the color palette is very limited, but it just works. It's so gorgeous. I normally give out about that and just moan and whinge about it a lot. A game this monochromatic, but they just make it work. Nice. Sometimes it's a pain in the ass to get an angle on the pilot. And there's another light transport, but there's no real reason to take it out, I don't think. Also, note that there's no one behind me, and now there are people behind me. Magical teleporting marines. Such impressive military technology, these teleporters. Alright, here we go.
Lead the way.
Head to the left of that KNRP Zero.
Right.
I absolutely love what's coming up. You see a crab form Argus at the top? That is not the biggest obstacle that we are gonna be running into trying to take this hill. The terrain is a lot more uneven here. We're not quite as swamped with gorgies and turrets and rocket launchers, but check this shit out. There's a lot more cover here, and it's spaced a lot closer together. And that's the reason. There is so much debris flying at you from overhead. I love this section. I adore it. So here is where we proceed. Oh, that was a nice headshot, by the way. We proceed carefully, because that falling debris, that's not just for show. That's not just scenery. That kills. Oh man, how does Vanquish shit on every other shooter so hard? Unbelievable. Oh man, a wave of them just spawned in. This is not good. One thing that's a little janky about this game is its spawn points. You really, really have to be careful about how you tread lightly at some points, because if you go up too far, you'll just instantly be surrounded by spawning in enemies. I think I handled that okay though. That's something that's kind of hurting, not having played this for like a year, is I don't quite remember all of the weird spawn points in some of these spots. The music here is surprisingly down tempo for Vanquish. Holy shit. This is so fucking cool, man. I like this so much. Vanquish, why are you so good? Alright, that was not even worth risking death. Duh. You're always fine here if you're behind cover. You're always safe from the debris anyway. If you're careful, you can boost under a lot of it too if you want to be stylish about it. This is something that I have not been doing very much of, is activating slow-mo mid-boost. I tend to always do this, activate slow motion out of a roll, which is limiting me a little bit. It's been causing me some problems, And that seems to just be a muscle memory thing for me. I have to actually think to activate AR mode mid-boost, whereas it's just kind of automatic for me to do it out of a roll.
We don't have time for this. Fly that thing down its throat.
Okay, I'll activate the engine and have Elena handle the rest. Elena, can you hijack this thing remotely?
Negative. The jamming signal is encrypted.
Damn. Guess this one's up to me.
Sam, what are you doing?
Watch and learn. Good at this falling out of transports thing, don't you think?
More like getting good at looking like an asshole.
Oh, we're just right into it.
No!
Did I accidentally skip a cutscene? Feels like I missed a little bit of setup there. I wasn't mashing the button to... Okay.
I told you to have them hold.
They didn't get the transmission. The signal channels are too strong. I'm broadcasting the hold order at maximum power.
Alright, so our next goal is to destroy the signal jammer that's preventing us from getting transportation for backup in here. And the signal jammer comes equipped with giant charged particle cannons and shit. We're not even there yet, though. We have some heavy lifting that we have to do before then. God damn it, I hear the Gorgis. Just got hope. Oh! I think I may have gotten through that with some iframes. Some lucky iframes. Oh my god. This is where it starts to really pick up. Vanquish is a game that starts at a 10 and just cranks it up constantly. You're at like a 30 by the end of this. Alright. Oh, shit. I know that one guy is probably not stunned behind me, so we'll just move forward. That's okay. I hear a Gorgie. Oh, shit. He's still going. Alright, he stopped. That is a terrifying sound, knowing how quick they move. It's just their last ditch kamikaze.
Hey, got one of the hatches opening up.
Here we go.
So we cleared out the first wave. Now we get Romanovs. This just keeps escalating. It just keeps going and going and going. That's one of the ones with a missile, the big missile. So, I'm gonna do my normal thing, because I love killing these things in this way. I'm gonna wait for him to fire the big one. Yeah, I just need to prod him a little bit more. Come on, you can do it. Nah. He's too obsessed with firing those miniguns at me right... Damn it, I missed my chance. Oh. Got it, homes in a little bit. Okay. So we're just gonna take him down normally. That's okay. Guess not every Romanov can be killed in a cool way. Whoa, watch that. He's doing his weird-ass little ice skating routine. This one is another one of the big missile guys. No sense in waiting, I guess. I'll just take him down the boring way. Oh, and there's another one over there. Let's see. Ooh, yeah. Yeah, now is the time for the rocket launcher, because we're going to be fighting a lot of Romanovs in this sequence. And some other new enemy types. One other new enemy type, rather. Yeah. If I can't get one of my favorite kills shooting their big rocket ab midair to blow them up, at least I can do that. Bias are super, super dangerous. They have a lot of attack types. Look at those giant shell casings it's ejecting. Oh my god, that's so cool. I've never noticed that before. Like I said, every time you play this game, no matter how many playthroughs you do, you'll constantly notice new details. Whether it's stuff going on in the background or just little things. It's the best. These things are also really tough. From a range, they're not too bad. They can soften you up pretty bad. They can overheat you, I think. But up close, they, I believe, can one-shot you very quickly. They're dangerous as hell. Yeah, I think that weak point's on their back. If I haven't pointed this out before, when you go into AR mode, it highlights enemy weak points. Yeah. That took a little while to highlight. I'm gonna overheat, but at least got a good couple pot shots in on its weak point. Yeah, those Bias are not to be messed around with. They're way more dangerous than Romanovs.
Not what I was after, but it'll do.
Oh, I just noticed we got the shotgun up to level 5 now. And the HMG is still maxed out. Rocket launcher. It's rocking 3 upgrades. Is all I have to do now? Is get on the platform with them? Let me see if I can maybe find some ammo for the HMG or something. This is one of those sections where if I'm too stubborn about my weapons, if I don't switch it up, or if I don't find ammo, if I'm unlucky, I can actually run dry. But I'm doing okay.
Merry-go-rounds.
You're welcome to take a ride.
That would be the jamming transmitter.
I just scanned it quickly. You won't be able to take that installation down with standard fire.
Shit.
We better take it down, or our reinforcements aren't coming! Bravo, aim for that red core! Don't stop shooting till you're out of ammo!
Sam did something in that cutscene that's supposed to be a hint for a gameplay mechanic that's not really that well documented in-game. If you're behind cover, you can smoke a cigarette and flick the cigarette out. You get 3 cigarettes per mission. You do it by hitting the boost button while you're behind cover. So you light the cigarette, you take a drag for a second, and then Sam will toss it. And because the enemies have really short attention spans, they'll see the shiny cherry at the end of the cigarette, and they will instantly start shooting at your cigarette so you can get some breathing room or take some pot shots. So we got a lot more Romanovs now. These ones are the easy flamethrower models. One of them did manage to overheat me, though. Gotta watch the rain. Whoa, fuck. I've been using the cigarettes periodically, but not as often as I probably should be. I'll try to show that off a little bit later. I think we have roly-poly droids coming out here. So this is... Ooh. Okay, Burns is just going through, like, random combat dialogue. Yeah, we do have roly-poly droids. These ones are being a little bit more difficult to deal with than the first ones we ran into. They're basically invulnerable. Ah, shit. While they're covered up. You can bounce them around, though. You kind of play soccer with them, too, if you want to melee them. Wouldn't recommend it, but if you want to just toy with them, you can. So this boss fight follows the rule of threes. You clear out a wave of enemies, you get a chance to shoot at the red core. Clear out a wave of enemies, rinse, repeat. Didn't mean to fire that rocket. So yeah, this is about as frantic as it's gotten so far. Look at Sam just chilling behind cover like that. This is such like... this reminds me of a treasure boss. I think the one I'm thinking of specifically is either the Stage 3 or 4 boss from Ikaruga. Except you're on the outside of it instead of the inside. And damn, there's a lot to this wave. Oh, hell. I just saw the particles coming together right before. Didn't have time to react. Okay, let's clear some stuff out while I'm in slow motion. I am being a little bit stubborn with my weapons. I think the next time... Shit, that goes behind small cover. Like the barricades, I think that goes over. But if I'm behind the APCs, I think I'm safe. Okay, I have to keep that in mind. I think this time I'm gonna try to use some rockets on it. Since I'm starting to run low on HMG ammo. I might save those for the next phase, though. I need it to open up the plating. Oh, not quite like that, though. Man, I'm trying to find some HMG ammo. There's so much stuff littering the ground right now, but just not what I need. I could switch to something else, but... Come on. Okay, yeah, I am safe behind the APC. So, rockets ahoy. The first one did not hit. The second one did. Oh, I'll get some ammo back if I upgrade it. Yep. So, I'm back up to 3. That should finish this off unless... No, it hit the side. Doing really poorly in the second phase. Fuck. Come on, before it fires. No, it's still gonna get the laser off. Kinda. Okay, we have one more wave, and this one is suitably tough. I think those are two of the drill Romanovs. Yep. Ah, that's not the grenade I wanted. Let's see if we can make the best of this, though. Shit! Oh my god, that rocket's so fast. Compared to some of the other missiles that the other enemies launch at you, that one's hard as hell to dodge. Oh, that one showed me his back. Perfect. There are a lot more Romanovs, though. There's you out of rocket ammo. Alright, got your back. Their weak points are on their back, by the way. In case it's not evident. I should have enough ammo left in the HMG to finish off this last phase. If not, there's plenty of stuff around the battlefield. I'm just trying to be stubborn. Sticking to what I have. You know what? I'll take the slow motion. I could probably finish it off with a quick reload. Before it gets a chance to fire at me and kill me. Yeah! Oh, that was sloppy, sloppy, sloppy. A win is a win, though. That's a fun fight. These last few missions, holy shit, I need to take a break after this. Whew, new tactical challenge available.
Signal's no longer being jammed. Well done.
All right, let's get these troop transports on the ground and head for the central building.
So much for your ride on the merry-go-round, son.
It's me.
Why did you attack? We were supposed to be cooperating.
Do you take me for a fool? Cooperation is mutual exploitation. We have merely exploited you first.
What are you saying?
I am saying that our spirit of cooperation may be a little less spirited. It is time to move on. We will speak again after your unconditional surrender.
Damn!
All right, I need a break before we do anything else. That's going to do it for now. Thanks for watching, everyone. Take it easy. Have a good one.